So women never got a chance to invest in stock markets from early ages.
I feel that empowerment is choice, and that as women, we should also not judge choices that other women make.
I just have to worry about that my income is enough to cover all my shopping bills. Not only that I can also pay EMIs, I can get myself whatever I want to.
Hello and welcome to Sisterhood with me, Shelly Chopra. Financial independence could be the first point of gender equality. And if women are able to talk, decide, and have their own money, that could potentially be the biggest agency they're looking for. At least a starting point where they don't have to bend down, survive, suffer painful relationships, whether it's with partners, whether with parents, whether with in-laws, just because they don't have money to live in this world. That is the big focus here on Sisterhood today. सबसे पहले वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस कि कौन सी ऐसी मिथ्स हैं अराउंड वुमेन व्हिच होल्ड देम बैक फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टिंग और पुश देम अवे फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टिंग. व्हाई डू आई से होल्ड बैक? बिकॉज़ वुमेन आर रिस्पांसिबल फॉर होल्डिंग देमसेल्व्स बैक. बट व्हाई डू आई आल्सो से दैट दे आर पुश्ड बैक? बिकॉज़ ऑफन मेन, मेनी अदर वुमेन डोंट अलाउ अदर वुमेन टू गेट नॉलेजेबल इनफ अबाउट इन्वेस्टिंग. सो देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑन वेरियस एंड्स. लेट्स लुक एट द वेरियस मिथ्स अराउंड दिस इशू. द फर्स्ट मिथ, that women are not interested in investing. Studies after studies have showed that when women are given the opportunity to invest, they get interested, they do look at various aspects of buy, sell, trade, and they do go out there to invest for their own betterment. Second, that women aren't money-minded. I think that's a complete myth. Women are interested in betterment of their lives, and if money is that source, so be it. Women are looking at money as a very important source of self-confidence today. Third, women are not as good as numbers, math, and all of that. I think it's high time that in 2021 we give up this thinking, because whether it's math, science, engineering, space, or investing, women are just out there pushing boundaries as much as possible. Yes, there are fewer numbers so far, but that's just a matter of time. That men are better investors than women? Of course not. A large number of studies, both in India and overseas, have showed that women are able to be just as good investors as men. Women need more financial education before they invest. Why? Why isn't this true for men? It is true for anybody who doesn't know anything about money, whether man or woman. If they have a starting point where financial literacy is part of school curriculum or it's part of their learning process in their career, I'm sure it would be an equal piece for all of them. The fact that women need more hand-holding to invest is another myth. Let's face it, we all seek advice. When we buy homes, when we do up our homes, we call an interior designer. So why are we so fearful about seeking an advisor who can tell us about money and investment? It's very important that we recognize that women don't need hand-holding. They need advice just as much as anybody else. Another myth, women are too risk-averse. They don't want to take risks. That might be the biggest myth of the last few centuries. They've taken risks at many times with their lives, with their money, with saving, with spending. And also, it has been noticed when they do enter the stock market, they're willing to take a chance on the money several times. So look at this scenario and imagine if we break all of these down, we would have a scene where women are very involved in investing and they start mentioning, my money is my money, not always somebody else's money. As a part of this discussion today, we've got several important voices. My first guest is going to be Rachna, who's an investment advisor, a chartered accountant, but most importantly, runs a YouTube channel that breaks it down for women and men as to how do you go about investing, primarily in the stock market, but also in various other instruments. We're going to break it down for you. कि किस तरह आप निवेश शुरू कर सकते हैं? Why at 21 आपके पास एक retirement plan होना चाहिए? All of those conversations are going to happen with Rachna. Rachna, thanks very much. First off, really, you know, this perception that women are bad investors. How do you break that?
I feel that women, especially Indian women, are absolutely fantastic investors. We have been, we have known this since a long time, I guess. It's just that where they used to invest was different. So women never got a chance to invest in stock markets from early ages. Women have been investing in gold. And in fact, there was a study which said that whatever gold India has, a major chunk of that is held by women in India. So that is what shows us how women have been investing. But it's just that they've been investing in gold or FDs rather than in stock markets.
So I hear you. And I think for many years, both as a business journalist and at She the People, one of the biggest pieces for me is financial independence. How important do you think that is in the process to gender equality?
I think that is the one most important thing, financial independence, because that gives you a separate identity, number one. Number two, that gives you a separate thought process altogether. You tend to be the decision maker rather than just listening to the decisions given by others.
Should society punish women who don't necessarily seek balance in the kitchen, mm-hmm. but are completely okay to have pure careers with an ambition to make money?
Again, it is something like, should society punish or not? The idealistic answer is no. But again, I'm saying the idealistic answer is no. It's about, again, it's an evolution. That's the same answer again. So I'll tell you, if one generation up of me has worked, they are very much open. But you go to the tier 2 cities, tier 3 cities, these women have never stepped out of their house. How can you really expect them to understand that it's okay if a girl leaves the kitchen? It's okay if she does a career by herself. So yeah. It's again education which is going to bring the maturity. And that maturity will take some time. So if you want to break the path, if you want to break the chains, then be ready. Society is going to say something to you. Then you have to have that I don't care kind of thought process and just follow your path.
Yeah.
Right. And once you prove yourself, then the same society is going to be like, wow, she didn't give a damn to the society. She chose a career. Proved herself.
But what can be done to increase financial awareness among women at scale?
I'll tell you my analogy. It's a little bit different, but I strongly believe in that. I tried to find out, like, even if I tell you my channel statistics, I have 2.17 million subscribers, is that 86% are males, just 14% are females. Okay. Now I try to dig down that why is that so? Why so few women are actually interested in stock markets? So they said that we know that it's very risky, and what if we lose money, then who is going to have sympathy on me if I lose my husband's money? Okay, so again that point comes in. Ki, it's husband's money which the girl is using, which she is trying to put in the stock market, and if she loses, then what? She'll have to give answers. I think that same analogy I can put for a girl learning to drive a car versus a boy learning to drive a car. When a girl is trying to learn to drive a car, what is the first fear in her mind? Arey, gaadi thuk gayi to kya hoga? If there's a dent in the car, who will pay for that big expense? It's better I don't drive only. That's the recourse she takes, right? Same thing I feel is the analogy for stock markets. Arey, if I lose money, then what? It's better I don't invest only. It's better my husband takes care of it. Even if he loses money, it's his money that he's losing. Then no one is going to ask me, and I'm not answerable. So I think the whole point again boils down to financial independence.
Rachna, thanks very much for joining us. Now a host of different people who've joined us on our platform to talk about the importance of financial independence. First, Shriya Pilgaonkar, I'd like to know, how have you gone ahead to ensure that you are financially independent as a young woman in the film industry?
It's just by observing my parents. My parents have a very equal partnership, equal relationship, where I've seen them respect each other, where I've seen them manage their own finances in their own respective way. And even in a very healthy manner, they've allowed each other to grow without being intimidated by anybody's growth. So I think that's very, very important. And more than really telling me anything, I've sort of seen my grandparents, my parents, and the importance of being financially independent was always made very clear to me. And not just financially independent, but I think in general independence. So, I mean, I'm the only child. So for me, the reference point was sort of observing my parents. They always gave me that freedom. And of course, having the security of a home helped, because for a long time, I, by the grace of God, didn't have to work for money or to pay rent, which a lot of, my friends who've come from other parts of the country had to. And I was aware of that privilege. But I was very clear that I want to be independent. I want to work hard. I want to spend for the travel I do. I want to completely take charge of my life, even though I am living with my parents. And understanding finances, especially, I think is very important because that just made me more responsible.
How did you stand apart, Shreya, in a business where your parents are a storied family in the world of films and theatre? How did you carve out your own space? And how much of money and financial independence did you give priority?
To begin with, I feel that empowerment is choice. And that as women, we should also not judge choices that other women make. I think it's perfectly okay if somebody wants to be a homemaker, because that itself is an extremely important responsibility, and it's a job in itself, you know. I mean, my mom, when she was working, she decided, you know, when I was growing up, she said she doesn't want to work for some time. That's because she wanted to not work. You know, she wanted to give her time to me. And that was not because she was a woman or a mother. That's just because she wanted to spend time with me. And that also is empowerment, to be in a position of choice. So I think we need to stop just thinking that, like, career, women who have careers, it's not just that women who have careers deserve respect. Every person deserves respect for the choices that they want to make, of course. Also, because I feel like what I'm sort of wary of is that I feel like a lot of women, because they're not financially independent, they do find themselves once in a while in a position where they are not able to make choices, or they are dependent because of that. So in that sense, that could be a restriction, you know, but it really depends. And the way I see, say, you know, some of my friends who are married now, or, you know, when I'm sort of observing relationships, it really truly is a partnership. I find it interesting to see when young couples are getting married, the way they deal with their finances now. It's not just, you know, the boys bought a house and you're there. No, you know, you have couples today renting a place together, sort of dividing the finances. So those notions, perhaps even if those parents of that generation might not understand, today it really is about trying to understand a partnership.
Also, I'd like to bring in at this point Tiska Chopra, who's an actor, of course, and has been a very important vocal voice in Bollywood, speaking up on very important issues. Along with her, I've got Aditi Kothari from DSP Investment Managers. Aditi is joining us as somebody who not only knows, you know, how money has to be made in the markets, but how important it is for women to ride that wave, as Rachna was pointing out earlier. Tiska, first to you, money and how women are changing the game with it.
I don't think that it was ever a question in my head that I needed to be financially independent. Mujhe hamesha hi pata tha ki mujhe is dharti pe agar jeena hai aur apni tarike se jeena hai, to mujhe apne paise kamane padenge. फाइनेंशियल इंडिपेंडेंस से आप जो चॉइसेस बनाते हैं उसके लिए आप जवाबदार नहीं होते हैं किसी को. ऑफ कोर्स यू फॉलो द बेस्ट प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ कि सबको सबका फायदा हो उसमें, बट छोटी छोटी चीजों के लिए या बड़ी चीजों के लिए भी आपको जवाबदारी नहीं होती है. आपने खुद पैसे कमाए हैं, आपको जो करना है आप कर सकते हैं उन पैसों के साथ. और वो मेरे लिए हमेशा से बहुत जरूरी था, और वो बचपन से ही माय पेरेंट्स ब्रॉट मी अप इन अ वे दैट that was extremely important. My mother has been a working woman all her life, and so have all my masis, my aunts, everyone's been a working woman. That's what I've seen. I don't have any other experience. Fortunately, my husband is a very strong feminist. He is the one who encouraged me, actually. Unhone hamesha mujhe kaha ki itni akal hone ka fayda kya hai ki agar aap khud apna kaam nahi bana sakte, aap baith ke wait karte rahoge ki koi aapko kaam de kya. तो उनके माइंड में कोई ऐसा है नहीं कि वो कमा रही है मैं कमा रहा हूँ, और ये डिस्कशन बहुत बड़ी नहीं है हमारे घर में कि कौन कमा रहा है. वो भी कमा रहे हैं, मैं भी कमा रही हूँ, और दोनों साथ में भी कमा रहे हैं. सो यू नो दैट इज एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल, उस पर कोई सवाल नहीं है, और ऐसा ही होना चाहिए. और मैं अपनी बेटी को भी यही बोलती हूँ, एंड आई से दिस टू हर ऑफन एंड वेरी क्लियरली दैट यू गॉट टू कैरी योर ओन वेट इन द वर्ल्ड, एंड दैट मीन्स having a skill set that can earn you at least money for your basic survival in the style that you want to live, that you should be able to afford yourself.
Aditi, coming to you, money equals confidence?
Money does give some power. It gives confidence more than it gives power. Mm-hmm. And when it gives you confidence and you know that you're not dependent on anyone else. So of course you'll be dependent on people for love and, you know, and of course, you know, more... you know, the more we talk in a more modern way, you don't need to depend on anyone for anything. and you need to love yourself is what they say. But when it really comes to money, it's even more practical than that. If you don't need to depend on anyone for money, for advice for money, and you can really truly be self-independent and be truly Atmanirbhar, why not? At some point in your life, you're going to need to do that. Today, you're either earning your own money, you're going to inherit some money, because today, Shaili, you know that it's not like the oldest boy in the family gets all the money. And also their laws have changed that even if you die without a will, it's equal to the, girls and boys in the family. And chances are, you may inherit some money at least. And of course, I've talked about life insurance, that the chances are that if you outlive your spouse, and chances are you will, you may be the beneficiary of life insurance. That's again your money. And the other thing is that, the divorce rates are increasing. So God forbid something untoward happen in your life. You want to be able to be that fully independent and have the confidence and therefore the power in your mind to know that I can actually do this on my own.
How important is it for women to look at various life stages as one where one should invest early, get involved in recognizing that their money is their money?
If you're a working woman, we all want to take some time off to have children. We get 6 months of maternity leave, but sometimes you want to take some time, more time. And I think that's very personal. And if you're used to getting, your salary, you may feel not so confident or feel less powerful because you're not earning your money in the time that you may take beyond the 6 months. But then plan it such, and you can get some passive income. That means if you've invested your money, you'll be getting some return from that money that you can then use, and you don't have to yet be dependent on anyone, even in that phase, for yourself and your own expenses. You need a financial advisor, who can hold your hand if you're, starting from scratch, and can really take you through the journey, help you to discover what your goals are, help you to segregate the money like I've talked about, tell you which instruments are right for which goals. Is money power? I think it's confidence, and somewhere confidence gives you inside power.
Thank you all for joining us. It's an absolute pleasure. As always on Sisterhood, many different voices. So here's one from Neena Gupta on money management by women.
It's going to take a long time. It's maybe going to take a century or maybe many centuries for this to change, because so deep rooted in our society. I think when more and more women start to work and earn, it will change. The whole thing will change. But it will take a long, long time. And the young girls who are right now earning and even like some more generations to come will have a very tough time. इसलिए मैं कह रही हूँ, अभी सिर्फ शुरुआत हुई, एक बूंद है. इतने बड़े सागर में, समंदर में अभी बूंद गिरी है. अभी बूंद को समंदर बनने में बहुत टाइम लगेगा. एंड दूसरी बात है, इट इज नॉट दैट आई एम सेइंग दैट मैरिज इज यूजलेस एंड यू शुड थिंक अबाउट योर करियर. वर्क तो अभी है, कल होगा, परसों शायद नहीं होगा, बट फैमिली विल ऑलवेज बी देयर. सो फैमिली इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. So I am not suggesting that you should not have a family and just work. Family is very important. So you have to find a balance to have a family as well as your career.
I'd like to bring in some perspective from Divya Gokulnath of Byju's. She's the co-founder there and leading some of the key initiatives at the company. Divya, thanks so much for joining us. First off, the importance of financial independence.
Financially independent because it helps you stand on your own feet. It helps you be strong enough to come out and say, this is what I want to do, and make a career for yourself. And like I said before, it's always better. It's lovely to have a husband who'll buy a diamond ring for you, but it's very, very nice and very proud to be able to do that for yourself.
How was it for you? What kind of support system did you create to be able to follow your own dreams? And why is that important?
So I keep time of the day to do everything that is important. I would not say I do everything, but whatever I think is important for me to do, I would do it, but I would do only one thing at a time. And I would give it 100% attention, 100% focus, and do it with 100% passion.
What would you say would be your one advice to women entrepreneurs as they set out to live their dreams and roll out their plans?
50% of the society are women, and we are the consumers of most products. So we bring something very unique to the table. We understand the need of a product very, very well. So if you are able to address that need through technology, because technology has the power to scale things, technology has the power to take your solution to every part of the world, then focus on that need and make sure it intersects with your passion for doing something. There's no point in just starting up for the sake of starting up. You need to passionately believe that what you're doing is trying to make a difference, and then use technology as an enabler to take it to the world.
Great. Thanks, Divya, for joining us. There you have it on Sisterhood, voices from all across the country, whether they are entrepreneurs, whether they are film industry leaders, whether they're chartered accountants. How important is women's financial independence today? Remember to tune in to She the People's YouTube channel, press that bell icon, and follow us for important discussions that every single woman should have.